Do you remember when you were a child? What did you learn? You learned how to speak, and later in school you learned how to read and how to write. For most people, that is all of their communication training in life. But when in life did you learn anything about listening or understanding another person? Chances are that you're like me and made it to adulthood without one person ever teaching you the critically important skill of seeking first to understand and then to be understood. To communicate effectively, we first have to understand each other. And the key is to first understand the other person. Everyone knows these conversations. One person is talking about something and the other person inserts stuff like cool, right, yes. Maybe you've done it yourself. I did it myself. That isn't understanding. That isn't even listening. That is called pretending to listen. And some people have it done so often that they became a master of it. You can't really tell if they are listening or just waiting for a keyword and then insert stuff like yeah or that's nice. And then there is another type of conversation, where one person is talking and the other person isn't even pretending to listen. He just waits for the other person to take a breath so he can interrupt and give his own opinion on that topic. Most people do not listen to understand, they listen with the intent to reply. This can be very problematic because everyone seems to do this, even in politics when they decide of the future of a whole nation. You have to cultivate the skill of listening. So how to listen properly? Stephen Covey recommends practicing the highest form of listening. He calls it emphatic listening. Emphatic listening means trying to see the world through the eyes of the other person. See where the other person is coming from, what are his beliefs and his thoughts. True understanding is about getting what the other person is feeling. You feel really amazing and start to like the other person if he is listening emphatically to your words. Remember this feeling you got from one of these conversations. And think about it, you can use this to make it so that everyone will like you, just through listening to their words. There are some tools Covey recommends to listen emphatically. And especially there is one tool which I really like most. It is called rephrase, meaning that you rephrase the sentence of the other person in your own words. And then ask the other person if he thinks that you got what he said. Imagine you talking to your friend and he is telling you a story about how he is mad at his mother because she stopped giving him his pocket money and she says he's old enough to earn his own money. Then you have to rephrase the sentence. A good start is, "So what I heard you say is that..." So the sentence could be, "So what I heard you say is that you hate your mom because you can't buy new clothes." I promise you, if done right, you will be astounded of how often you are wrong and the other person say, "No, that's not what I meant at all." You can even try this with a friend and believe me, you won't forget this conversation. If mastered, listening emphatically can be a very powerful technique when talking to your girlfriend, win friends or even in business. So use this tool and make use of habit 5 and seek first to understand and then to be understood. This was my video on habit 5, seek first to understand then to be understood. Click here to watch my video on habit 6, synergize. Feel free to share this video with a friend who this could help. If you like this video, click the like button and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.